How's everyone today? I'm fine, thank you. And you? Okay, today I'm going to work with, I had an idea. I want to take all the trumpet parts and I want to test something. I want to do another reverb pass on them. I know it's layers and layers of reverb, but. And then mix them down into one, to a stereo track, and then reverse it, and then do it again with a reverb. So it's kind of bi-directional reverb smear. Let's see what happens. I don't know if I'll keep it, but we'll see. Okay, you probably didn't hear much of what I said, but I'm going to do a two-direction reverb smear. Like a reverb it, and then reverse it, and then reverb that. And then so it'll be fading in and fading out. I'm just going to try it on one track, see if it works. And if it does, then I'll try it for all the tracks separately, but in one go, if I can. I've never tried it before, but we're going to try it. I'll just try it with the last section first. Okay, I just learned that the damp knob, you turn it up, it doesn't dampen it more, it dampens it longer. It takes longer to dampen. Oh, that's interesting. Good to know. Oh yeah. Okay, we're mixing down. Alright, that sounds terrible, so I'll just, while that's going on, won't take long. We'll just talk a little. Talk. It's not gonna take long. How's everyone doing today? Good? I'm good. You good? We're good.
Okay, almost finished. And then I'll stick that at the way after the end of the piece and do it again. And reverse it and do it again. Strange, it's not coming through. I know why. That's why. Okay, let's take that and reverse it. There's a ton of low-end rumbling there. I can see it in the spectrograph. Maybe I should get rid of that. That did it. Look at that. Look how clean that is right there. That's awesome. It worked. Okay. Exporting again. Calls two. Just kind of turn that down a bit. Okay, now I grab it and lay it in again. Looks gorgeous, look at that. Two glowing orbs. Can you see that? No? Yeah. No, you can't see it. Try to need to see it. Looks like two suns in the sunset. And here's what it sounds like. I should also note that before I mixed these down, I took each of these six tracks here and I spread them out over the left to right from panning, so that's why it sounds more expansive now, because it's kind of like antiphonal trumpets, which I love. And that's hundreds of years old. That's a medieval Renaissance kind of technique. Put the brass in different parts of the cathedral, way up high in the cathedral, so it sounds, echoes around, and it sounds like it's coming from heaven itself. I just love that sound. Antiphonal brass. Yeah, remember how crummy my original tracks were of this trumpet stuff that I recorded, just one note at a time? And you process it out and iron it and run it through the works, and it ends up sounding like this. I think I'm going to still filter this a little bit, maybe tweak the EQ, but other than that, it's sounding pretty good. I said, I think I like them in the other order, the original order. I don't know. Maybe I like that order. They're separated by silence, so I could easily cut them and transpose them. I don't mean transpose musically, but just swap them around in order. You gotta be careful when you use some words. Some words mean one thing in music than it does in other things. You transpose something, means you swap their order, right? But in music, it means change their key. Gotta watch my P's and Q's. I am getting an international call, so I'm gonna go silent for a bit. Okay. They hung up before I could pick it up, but I could see that it was my political party calling me to see if I voted, and they sent me a text message. So I said, yes, I voted. I voted at the earliest possible moment that I could vote. So I'm done. I voted. Now I just sit back and see what happens. Okay, where were we? All right, okay. Okay, this previous one that before flipping it around, or no, that is the flipped one, isn't it? I think definitely sounds different. I'm agonizing over what order to put these in. Yeah, I should probably stream during more prime time for my friends, so that maybe you could join in the chat and tell me what to do when I come to a decision that I can't make by myself. Of course I can make it. Do I flip the order of these last two chords, or do I leave them the same? Even number says I leave it, odd number says I flip them. And the roll. It's odd. It was a 3. So I'm flipping them. That's how we make decisions around here. How about we overlap them a little at the in-between? That way, for a moment, we're gonna hear all 12 tones at once. Why not? Let's try. Just for fun, I want to see what they sound like right on top of each other. It's going to be weird. I can't wait. I love it. All right. Decision time. Introduce one, bring in the other on top of it, let the first one fade out, the other one dominates, and it fades away. Okay. I had them leveled weird. Again. Yeah, Georgi Ligeti, eat your heart out. I know what you're thinking, Izzy. And yeah, I'm stealing this from Georgi Ligeti. It's easy to see why Stanley Kubrick loved his music. Alright, I love it too, so I'm stealing it. It's really a simple idea. Lots of people have done it, but I'm doing it now. to hear it again. Okay, that's how I'm gonna end it, for sure. That just kind of annoys me. Maybe it'll make more sense later. If not, it's gone. The end of these three here should be more abrupt. Not staggered like that. At the end, I'm doing away with the washes, and this kind of makes it a more, like we're having a more pure expression of what the sounds are at the end. I want to get that kind of heavenly distillation of meaning, or whatever. I don't know what I mean. Okay, I think we're onto something here. That's where it should end. Okay, I just threw this thing over here in the beginning. Let's hear what it actually sounds like. I may not use it, but I thought maybe bookend the piece with those. Kind of simplified version of it in the beginning, and then end with it more kind of developed and angelic and weird, and then angelic, weird, angelic. Now we're mixing. You know, I could go through that whole thing and cut out all that low end on those other tracks that are similar, but I think we can leave some of that in there. I don't think it's that bad. I don't mind if it's a little dirty down in that low register. That's okay. What I hope happens is that with these washes of radio talk in the background and Yeah, while that's going on, hopefully the listener will forget about it, and just kind of, just like living in the city, you forget about the noise. And then when the end comes, when it's gone, and all you have are the tones, then you can see things, you know, like, the contrast should be like, oh, wow, my head is clear, that kind of thing. We'll see. I'm looking at this. That orange-red slice down the center there, that's the pitch we're hearing. The rest of it is just cloudy around it. And you can see this light pinstripey here. Those were the kind of overtones that the flanger was making. See how they're gone now. That's beautiful. That's an instrument tuner. I need to find a big old spectrogram like I had with Cubase. It'd be nice if I could get a bigger looking version of this. The inline is just, maybe I just don't know how to make it bigger. What was that transition? It's like a dominant 7. Yeah, I'm not too afraid to hear kind of vanilla chords, like basic jazz chords in the in this kind of music, because I mean, when you're, how many times have you walked down the street and heard two cars honking and it creates this sort of major chord or, you know, dominant seven or something like that? And you go, oh, that's a dominant seven chord. And it's just two cars honking at the same time. If it happens in life, it's going to happen in the music too. So there you go. That's my excuse. I don't know if it's just that tal flanger, the T-A-L tal flanger that I used with this, but I've never had this much fun with a flanger. It usually sounds very cheesy and obvious, but this just, you hear the original tone and then these beautiful glistening harmonics just sail out over the top. I just really, maybe it's the properties of the trumpet in the harmon mute that bring that out. But I just like how it sounds. I usually stay far away from things like flanger and chorus, because they sound like flanger and chorus. This just kind of brings out the shimmering, you know, harmonics. I have to focus and hear that bit again, because it's the last stage of the song, so I'm gonna go. I'm gonna shut up and listen. I think I should start those earlier. And I'm gonna. Which means I have to drag everything from the back forward.
คนที่ไม่ได้นักเที่ยวอย่างคุณไปกลับมาแล้วกักตัว14วันที่พักหลับไทยที่10คืนเดินทางไปเจอคนอื่นด้วยแต่นักท่องเที่ยวเนี่ยคุณหลังนึง
Why are we suddenly hearing that? Clearly, something happened, something wrong.
มีกิเลสเป็นตัวนำซึ่งเอาเขามา14วันแต่ไอ้14วันที่คุณประกาศนั้นเนี่ยมันไม่ตรงกับคุณที่ไปคุณกลายเป็นคุณไปเปิดหาด
Something got moved. That's what it is. I know when I shift it down. That's what I did. Oh, phew. Okay. So we're not supposed to hear this at all. This is just a trigger track for the vocorder. The vocorder that affects this. It's very subtle, but it's there. Okay, phew, fixed. There, it doesn't sound like it's ending yet, so yeah, that works. We'll have to fix the ending then. Bum 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 bum. Don't do it. Don't sing it. I shouldn't have done that because now you're going to hear it every time. Sorry, I got distracted. Gotta do it again. If you hear the little bumpy, shimmering kind of blah, 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 that's the triggered track. It's the vocorder being triggered by one of those talk radio clips. Not the purple one that we're hearing normally. This is the triggered track for the vocorder. It's subtle, it's really subtle, but. And that's how it ends. Right, so I think that's it. I think that's all we're going to do for today. I gotta save it. MixBus is really good about, if you forget to save, that it reminds you. It doesn't let you quit without saving, which is good for me, because as my friend Izzy mentioned, there's no pain like having worked 4 or 5 hours on something and then losing it to a undone save or something, or unbacked up, or but MixBus seems to know this about composers that we tend to do that. So there are all kinds of, you could, all these different save sessions that you have. Every time you save, you can go back to any one of them, and it's, you can set it up to kind of auto save, that kind of thing. So I save often, save early. Okay, so I will mix this down after I've stopped streaming, which is now, and well, I guess we'll talk to you later. Thanks for being here with me, and we'll see you soon, probably tomorrow. And okay, I will probably, the next step on this piece is to give it, sleep on it, and then give it one more listen and see if anything pops up that I didn't hear today. And it's, you know, that'll probably be a couple days of that until it's finally done. And then we'll move on to isomerism 3. Okay, thanks a lot. I will see you next time. Adios. Adieu.